building
what
here.
What is this building here, Ray?
This building used to be the old school 1873 Lowell Grammar. And then as time went on, it became part of it. As they built a new school. Then it became part of the town hall, moved in. And then they had a doctor's office in it, and they had multiple, they had like a town hall where Lion's Den would meet. There's about 30 functions this building played in this town through its lifetimes. Upstairs is an auditorium, it was called Citizens Hall, and they held minstrels and plays and silent movies and roller skating and just a ton of stuff that I have listed and documented. And now it's just a doctor's complex, that's all it is, except for upstairs. The upstairs, not, it's just an auditorium, but it's kind of like abandoned. There's just stuff in it, but not functional at this time.
The doctor's down the first floor?
Yes, they have the whole main floor.
Have the doctors reported any kind of activity? Do they hear anything?
I've never asked them. I asked some of the girls, and they're kind of like, they don't want to know about it, and they'll say, nah, nah. But I brought in some pictures that were from upstairs, and then they had to kind of like rethink it, like, well, I guess maybe.
Alright. So what's going on right now?
We're going to take a walk through the building, we're going to go in with Ray, and we're going to go upstairs and check out the auditorium.
Follow me. When the town had it, they didn't care too much about what was happening above them. It was just in pretty bad shape. So it was leaking, but they moved on. You know, they sold us and they could have a new building, so they ended up buying it. But, you know, we put in roof, and now we got to do the repair. We've been putting insulation in all the walls, and it's been wiring that we run, because there's not much electrical up here. And we just use it as a fill-in. You know, if we get caught up, we kind of putter away, and then everything will get sheetrocked and redone.
Yeah.
And put it back with all hardwood floors.
Where are the slots on the wall with a wood?
That's where all the wires. It was easier to run across for all electrical than it was to go up and down and just waste so much wire.
Yeah.
So, to get outlets in, and, you know, switches.
So, is there anything up here that's original, old, antique, that you know of, like the piano?
The piano was here. There's some old, that old bench up there, that's pretty old. A lot of the stuff in the middle, that was my stuff in the barn, from the barn. There's some showcases here that are pretty old. If they weren't out of this building, they were in some building in town, and they were just brought here, you know, fire department. A lot of the old school desks, they're all here.
So those are the desks from the school when they were?
Yeah, not this, well, these probably not as old as this building. They probably come from their other school, you know. But then they consolidated three schools to make a new one. So a lot of this stuff is up here. Boy Scouts used to meet up here, town hall would have their meetings up here, dances, minstrels, silent movies, basketball.
Wait,
even a murder.
Basketball?
Case. Yeah, they used to basketball.
Wait, what did they do, basketball up here?
Yeah.
Like a game?
Yeah.
They played basketball here?
Yeah.
Oh, hold on one second. Wait. So they played basketball in this room?
Yes.
This room does not look big enough to play basketball.
It's like a half court.
Yeah. But it was the biggest thing they had for his day.
Right. And how long ago was that?
Well, this building is like 1873. at some point in time, this stage was built later. This was one large room.
Oh, okay.
You can crawl under it, and you can see the high, see the wainscoting? Yeah. You got the same thing under there, and you got the boards, and you see there's no paint on it. It's bare, clear, like clear wood, beautiful wood.
So part of that wall wasn't there either.
Right, none of that wall was there, and the stage was not there. That came in later.
Well, that's a little bigger.
Yeah.
Looks like it might have been just big enough to be a, maybe a regulation.
You know, and it wasn't like a big time game thing anyways back then. I mean, it's a small scale. It looks, you know, not a lot per class. I have a lot of photos of all the classes that graduate from here, eighth grade. And they're small classes.
And the classes were downstairs and this was their gym?
Yeah, all the classrooms were downstairs. All your kitchen and all your bathrooms were in the basement. You had a girl's side and you had a boy's side.
Hmm.
Everything was in the basement, all your plumbing.
It was him. So, you said that there aren't a lot of reports, or aren't any reports, or reports they don't want to talk about?
Well, I've never let anyone up here.
But do they hear it downstairs?
Yeah, like doctor's offices downstairs, do they report any unusual activity?
No, they wouldn't. If anything weird happens, there's some stuff that goes on, but they tie it to me. They won't admit that it's up here. They say, raise in here, get them out.
Oh, okay.
So,
okay.
You know, they just kind of tie some of the stuff that goes on. To it. So, if I walk out, then everything goes kind of okay.
All right. And have you been told that you think some of the young children at your house are associated with this location?
I've been told that because of all the kids that have been here and where there is a lot of activity with kids there. Of course, across the street is where the mill dam is, and we've made a swimming hole there, but also I've done some research, and over a 100-year period, you know, I sat on one end, and I had a friend sat on the other end, as much as old as documentation they had to see how many people have drowned there, and so far we're up to 32 people.
People like kids or
mostly kids. I got all the names, the dates, the ages, and that's over a 100-year period. It's in the stream of the canal.
Right in this area.
33 people.
Yeah, 32. It's 30 or 32 people. I have the list at the house, and I'm thinking of probably doing a monument because it's a beautiful place, but it can be a dangerous place, and people got to know how many lives have been lost over there. No one knows that. They don't realize. Most of the older people only know the tail end and of three or four people, but they don't know what's happened in a 100-year period.
Right.
That water used to be a lot swifter, faster, because the mill was powered by it. So they needed the dams to be open. The current in the canal was very swift, and if anyone fell in it, it sucked you down. The current, you know, and there's people they'd hay in the summertime, they'd go jump in the water, cool off, their body had a shock and drown. Another kid fell in, and an older guy saw him. He went in after him. He drowned too. So there are a lot of them are in pairs. There's two brothers. There's a kid and a man. I mean, there's just you know, if you were to look at it, it's like holy smokes, a lot of people. You know, for a small area, that's a lot.
And that's right across the street, you said.
Yep.
So there's a lot.
So who knows if some of that activity, you know, is all this is just together. Right.
So there's lots of deaths right across the street from exactly where we are.
Yes.
Exactly. So a lot of death and sorrow.
Accidental deaths of young people.
Yeah.
So that could be contributing to activity at Ray's house. It could be contributing to some activity that's going on in this building, in the mill.
In the mill. The center of this town. The center of this town has a lot of things.
because this is such a small area, we may only spend a few hours here this evening, but we'll definitely want to come back.
Yeah.
If that's all right with you, if we can manage
fine.
That.
That's fine. Just let me know, because like downstairs, you don't want to pass the other doors that are in. Just come up here. If you go past those other doors, the alarms will go off.
Okay.
And that is loud.
We'll go down and show us which doors.
Yeah.
I think tonight what we'll do is we'll start off with a light EVP session. We can go dark EVPs and maybe like a, ghost box session. And, maybe
a storm coming, so anyone who's a tri-field meter of the K3 meter.
Right.
And there is a big attic to this. You get that ladder there, there you can go up and grab a thing, and there's a catwalk up there.
Catwalk for
did
what?
Did this used to be open?
No. But it's big. It's
why is
one
there,
big.
Why is it so big?
It must be eight.
Oh, this pitch of the roof and this width.
Yeah.
It's massive.
Did it use it as a facility area?
No, nothing, just attic.
Just a big old area with a cat.
And there used to be a big cupola up above, big. And there's a wooden ladder, you can go up to it, and there was a trap door to go through the roof and into that. But that's been sealed. Ladder's still there, and you can see where the base of it is.
Yeah. We're here outside of the schoolhouse. We just took the tour. And during the tour, we learned a few things about the inside of the building. The floor that we're on is a gym, or used to be a gym, an auditorium, things like that. We did learn some disturbing news about across the street here. There's a stream that runs across the street, and the stream is used to power, or was used to power the mill. The old American woolen mill, which you can't see from here, but it's across the street from the mill agent's house. And the mill agent's house owner owns this school, which is literally across his lawn. You can see it's right there. That's the mill agent's house. This building right here, that I'm standing right in front of it, is the school, and he owns the school as well. He's always been told that the kids that were associated with this school, some of the kids associated with this school, were at his house. So, and tonight we just learned that there have been 33 deaths by drowning of young individuals, maybe not little kids, but, maybe not little kids like the little kids that are said to be over at the mill agent's house. They could be teenagers, they could be, middle school kids, but they drowned right across the street. Over the last 100 years, at least 33 victims. Some also with the people who jumped in to save them. It's very sad. And we didn't even think of that aspect. It never even occurred to us that there would be drownings across the street, let alone 33 of them. So we're getting ready to get our stuff, and we're going to go upstairs, and we're going to do probably an EVP session. We'll do a ghost box session. And we'll likely do a flashlight session. So, we're looking forward to doing that. Hope you guys hang out with us. Let's go see who we can make contact with, if anyone. It could be an interesting night. Ready? Let's go.
So what I was thinking is, if we put two people here and two people there, and we might be able to just do, we'll do four cameras. So if we go cross with each camera, so we're not interfering with each other from the center, going both ways, that way, we can get all of us up close, but get everything in the background at the same time.
Yep.
I think we ought to set up a couple cameras too.
You think what?
I think we ought to set up a couple of trigger objects. This was a schoolhouse with a lot of kids, and I know Teresa has some toys in her backpack. Do you have any in yours?
I had some outside, but I didn't bring them in.
Okay. You still got some in yours, Teresa?
Yes.
So we'll set up a couple toys, and we want to make sure, I think, we get towards the coat room. That was a room that the kids were used to going to every single day, and towards that backstage. So we got a camera coming in to get that stage. This side, I'm gonna try and get it so we can go towards that piano. I'm hoping maybe someone, does that work?
Oh yeah.
It does.
Oh yeah.
So we can listen for tones tonight. Oh. Sure the kids used to play with it. There's a nice little bell on it. It does still roll. We want that where it'll be seen by a camera. So after we get the camera set up, we'll try and figure out where we want to put that, where it can be seen. We're kind of tight on space.
All the way back there, down like the
over by that, yeah.
Well, even better, right up on the stage. Like, we're too far away.
Well, let's put the cameras up. Okay. And then we can get them in focus. But we got a lot of good trigger objects. Trigger objects that were here, so they're used to them. They might be playing with them to begin with.
All right, let's set up. Let's go.
I'm going to go low with these two to try and so we can get the stage in behind us and go up high with or medium on these two.
We're going to take this Olympus audio recorder and we're going to go place it over here by the piano.
By the piano or on the piano?
On the piano.
I think you said by the piano. So technically you're actually going to put it on the piano.
Yes.
Set it low in case we can hear the piano keys going. So is it recording right now?
Yes, this is Tony Olympus. You're on the left-hand side of the front of the piano. And it is 8:38. You are recording. We are in the top floor of the schoolhouse in Vassalboro.
Okay, we'll set this Sony PX820. I'm going to put it over here by the truck with bell on it. And get it going. Let's see. Alright, this is John Sony PX820 in Vassalboro Schoolhouse. It's 840. We're putting this right in front of the fire truck. I'm setting it down. I'm going to ring the bell that's on the truck so we know what it sounds like. And we're going to leave that one running there.
Teresa, how hot is it in here?
How hot is it in here? It's hot. So, actually, not too bad right here.
So if we get a cold spot,
oh, we're gonna know it.
Oh, yeah,
we're gonna know it because it's swelteringly warm in here.
It would be unusual if we got a cold spot.
I would welcome a cold spot. Bring me a cold spot.
So we're gonna take the camera, this camera, the one that Tony's holding, and we're gonna put it on a tripod and put it back a little farther so we can get all of us in one shot. That way we have each individual person on a shot and a camera that shows everybody at one time. So if there's any question of what one person does, you can see everybody at one time and cross-reference that way. So.
Okay, everybody set?
Yes.
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 Hello? If there's anyone up here with us, we'd like to speak with you. We'd like to speak with anybody who wants to communicate with us. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna introduce ourselves. And then after we tell you who we are, we'd like for you to tell us who you are. We're from ZeroLux Paranormal. And my name is Kat.
My name is Tony.
My name is John.
My name is Teresa.
Can you tell us who you are, please? We have a couple of devices that are around this auditorium. And the devices are designed to record your voice. It doesn't cause any pain. It doesn't steal any part of you. It just, all it does is it records the sounds that you make. One of the ones that I'm using it's right here. It has two or three red lights coming out of it. Tony has one next to, he's gonna raise his hand. He has one next to himself and he's pointing to it right now. John has one, and he's pointing to his right now, so right next to him. And all three of these are on these cases here, right beside us. There's actually another one at the entrance, which is far away from us. If you need to be far away from us, you can talk right at the door there, at the on the top step. There's also another one on the piano. So if you like to play the piano, or you just want to sit on the bench over there, or you're looking at us from over there in the corner, there's one over there. There's also another one at the stage. Is there anyone here who played basketball here? Is there anyone here who is really good at basketball? If there's a really good basketball player here, someone who's really, really good at basketball, to play basketball here, can you please make a sound that you would make during basketball, like the squeaking of your sneakers on the floor, or bouncing, the bouncing of the ball, or the swish of the hoop? Let us hear something about you playing basketball.
There's actually a basketball behind me in a box. You can roll it over to us. What was that?
My feet.
Cat moving.
Okay. So we're not here to hurt you in any way or disrespect you. We just want to communicate and know you're here, or hear your story. But we need to know that you're here. So if you could make a noise to let us know that you are here, that would be great.
What was that? Is that you guys?
It wasn't me.
What did you hear?
It was just like a snapping crackle.
Yeah.
Thought it wasn't you.
It wasn't me.
I thought it came from over here.
It wasn't me though. Okay.
Could you do something a little more distinctive, like play a note on the piano or ring the bell on the truck that's on the stage?
Is there anybody here from the river? The stream? Ray told us, giving K2 activity.
Really? Can anything see that? You had K2 activity? Well, all of our phones are outside, right?
Yep. Mine's in my pocket, but it's off. It's only here if we have an emergency. Make sure it's off. Here it's off.
That's Tony again.
Is it right there? That's interesting to get K2 activity there. All the power's off in here. Tony breathing.
Well, I just heard like a moan. Did you hear? Do you have headphones on? John, do you have headphones on?
Yes.
Did you hear the moan?
No, I didn't.
Oh my gosh, it was a man. It was a like a teen boy. And it went like this is what it sounded like. Mm-hmm. I'm starting to feel cool right there. You? Are you feeling cool right here?
Yeah, I've been feeling cool over here. It's been kind of creeping over.
Yep. Oh.
That's why I keep looking over there.
I think either I just moved weird and my t-shirt made a weird movement, but felt like I got poked very lightly in the back of my left arm here. Is there a young teen, or is there a teen boy here who drowned in the river across the street? Did you get to the shore and not realize that you had drowned? I'm feeling cooler on my leg now. And it's like all in here.
I don't feel it on my leg, but I feel it on my back and the back of my neck. My back is like really cool.
Did you come over here because you didn't know where else to go? Because it's the first building that you saw, the first public building that you saw? Where are you? Where are you? Were you a teacher? You can turn on that flashlight near the one of the flashlights near the stage if you were a teacher. What? Okay.
Did you hear that?
What was that?
That sounded like the bell.
That sounded like... That definitely sounded like the bell, you guys. That couldn't be more obvious.
I put my hand up because something tapped on my recorder like 3 or 4 times.
Okay. Okay, so you were a teacher, a female teacher, thank you.
And it just did it again.
Okay, we're gonna... Whoa, whoa. What was that?
I don't know what that was, but it was definitely some...
Deep...
movement or something.
Thump.
Oh, oh. I keep hearing sounds, and I keep thinking that there's something... Did you hear that? To the female principal? Did you start out as a teacher and then make it all the way up to principal? Teresa?
Something cold just went right down my arm.
Really?
Did you see me jump?
Yep.
It like went right down my arm.
Okay, so you used to be a... I'm gonna do a timestamp. 9:38. 9:38. So you used to be a teacher, but you worked your way up and you wound up making it all the way to principal. That's pretty good. So you must have been at this school for a long time.
I thought I heard a female vocal when I did that.
Did you teach all the subjects? Tony? What?
I feel like someone touching my back of my neck. I heard something go like over here behind me.
Well, it just exhale, or was it, you made it sound like it's mean.
Well, it was, yeah, that's just the way it sounded when I came from. It was that type of tone.
So it was like an older man?
What was that?
Yeah, what was that? It was almost like the sound of one of those camcorders, but...
Like yep, that's what I heard.
That was Teresa, by the way, doing it twice.
I don't know what that was. That's why I sat up, because I don't know what could be making that noise. I'm afraid that every time I look behind me, I'm going to see something.
Uh-huh.
You're clear. What? Who
that
did...
That was my chair I'm leaning forward. I just wanted to see the temperature. It feels like it's gotten cooler.
It's 80.8.
It's actually gotten warmer.
And it does feel cooler.
It does, because, I mean, not sweating. It's been like that over here for a little bit. Like, if I touch my skin is cool. I'm cool.
Kyle,
yeah, you are.
Yeah.
Who's the man who grunted? Where are you? I'm gonna move. The man who grunted? Who are you? Were you a janitor?
I just yawned.
One of the guys that cleaned the building? Made sure that nothing happened to the building? Maintenance man?
John breathing.
Thank you. Bet you didn't expect to see us tonight, huh? That was you guys, right?
No.
That wasn't you guys?
That was right here.
That was over there?
It was
like right here.
Right there.
Are you this close?
They've been this close. You haven't been feeling that over here?
I'm trying to block some stuff out because I'm near terrified to turn around.
My hair has been like... That's the dog.
Oh, thank the Lord, that was the dog. Thank
my God. Hair has been like standing up. I am like, my skin is cool. I mean, I feel like there's been something going right round and round my chair over here.
John moving.
We've been up here for about 45 minutes doing this EVP session, and it started out pretty slowly, but we started talking to not children but adults, different possible adults that could be here. And the moment we started talking about the possibility of a principal being here, all kinds of things started happening. John started feeling things. He felt cold on his back. And when we went to female principal, what happened? More cold spots over here. And then Tony heard a man speaking next to his ear. He did like a grunt in Tony's ear, so I just asked if it was a male possible janitor or somebody who watched out over the building, and there's a sound right after. We also heard sounds back there, possibly the ringing on the fire truck. What?
The bell.
The bell, right. So that yipping is the dog outside. We know what that is. We're going to keep asking questions, hopefully, to some of the adults that may have worked here. They may have had good reason to be attached to this building.
Okay, I'm over here on this side now where you were earlier. You want to come touch my hand or my arm. Me only. Or you could really impress us and play us a tune on the piano or ring that bell on that truck.
Probably if it played three notes on a roll on the piano, we'd have to chase Cat out of the building.
Can you stop, Teresa?
There was like a double tap from over there.
I saw something between you two just a second ago.
Oh.
It was like a light or something, and it went like this down. I was looking right at it. It's like a pinpoint light or something.
I have to say, for a while when I came over here, I felt good. And now I have that really, the same feeling I had over there, that like there's somebody like right here. Breathing down my neck.
Whoever, if there's anyone here that does not mean well, this is not the place for you. You don't belong here.
if you want to communicate with us, you're going to have to make some obvious sounds in this room. If there's somebody here who wants to communicate with us, tap on one of these showcases.
Time limit.
In the next 15 seconds, wrap your knuckles right on the glass or on the side of one of these showcases.
Time's up. There's so much stuff in here, it should be really easy to make a nice loud noise for us. Can you do that, please? If not, can you let somebody else come in that would like to talk to us politely in a non-threatening way? What was that?
A knock back here.
Is that somebody else talking to us? Okay, who would like to talk to us now? Could you tap on something or make a noise to let us know of your presence here?
Wow.
Was that someone breathing over there?
That was, did you even hear that knock?
It was a knock?
It was a tap, like way back there. It was a wicked loud. Need a drink.
Can you tap closer to us, please? There's all these cabinets around us. Stacks of chairs and desks. Come closer to us and knock on something. Or come closer to us and knock over something.
Breathing.
There is a piano in the room.
Felt like something just crawled on my foot.
See, and it felt like something just went on my arm. That's weird. That is weird. That's weird that you said that because we basically would have felt it at the same time. Because I looked over here because it felt like something very lightly went like that on my arm.
Yeah, felt like it went right up my foot.
Breathing.
We need you to do something that our equipment can hear or see, though. Can you please do something that's loud, distinctive, or something that the camera can see, like knocking something over? Just don't knock over any of the equipment. We'd really appreciate it. Can you do that in the next 10 seconds, please? We need you to try really hard. That was John's chair. Please make a loud noise. I know you can do it. Anybody hear anything over there?
Heard a tap.
Thank you. We'd like to welcome anybody who wants to be pleasant and nice, or even the other person that was here, as long as you're polite and you don't scare anybody, and you keep your distance from the people who don't want to be touched, you're more than welcome to come back and talk to us. If there is somebody here, could you please turn on a light in the next 8 to 10 seconds? This might be your only chance to communicate with somebody for quite some time. So it would be great if you would communicate with us. You can talk into one of the recorders, we'll hear it later. But it'd be really nice to know that you're here right now by making a noise or turning on a light. John's stomach. It's like nothing.
I know, it was like maybe some stuff was happening and we thought we were hearing things, and now it's like absolutely nothing. You know that car is up there, that fire truck type car is up on the stage right now and it has a bell on it. Did you just hear
that? Was Teresa's. No, I heard her cry.
Yeah, I inhaled just before you said that, so I almost think that might have been like I, you know, did a deep inhale.
But it was out.
I didn't hear the voice. I heard the crack.
Yeah, that was my sneaker.
Someone else rang that bell earlier. Can you do it?
That was my foot. All you have to do is push it.
There was Teresa's, so mine's gonna go up.
10:42!
Oh, no, wait a minute.
That wasn't mine.
No.
What was that? If it's 10:42, that wasn't either one of your
watches. No.
No, it wasn't. My watch hasn't been going off.
Is that flashing or getting ready to die?
And it's getting lower, too.
But does it make a sound?
The K2 can make a sound on it.
But is that what it sounds like?
Yeah.
Like it sounds like that?
Yeah. Can you turn the K2 off and back on?
We're down to 79.9 now. That's on the back, right?
Yep.
We're going to start wrapping it up here pretty soon. Oh. It just scared me bad.
What is that?
Siren for the fire station.
That's not the siren for the fire
station.
What is that? Something whistling, like a plane or a truck or...
Shh. I think that was in this building. I think that was in this building.
Can you do that again? That's the beep that it makes.
Yeah. But that wasn't the beep that we heard.
No, it wasn't.
We're going to have to show the camera.
I know, I was just trying to see if I keep...
No, we're going to have to show the camera the sound, because that wasn't the sound that...
Yeah, turn it on, put it in front of the camera and turn it on.
It was a beep, just like a watch.
It was just like a watch.
Yeah. Okay, hold on. Here, I'll show this one. I'm closer.
Okay, yeah, good.
Okay, ready?
Yeah.
And turn it on.
Not even.
Close. No, not even close.
Do it again. So, Teresa's going to show us the sound that the K2 meter makes to compare it to the sound that we heard just like a few minutes ago, that we thought was our watches, but it wasn't anybody's watch. You doing the sound?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Teresa moving.
If my audio recorder went off...
Where is your audio recorder?
This one, the battery was down to like 1. I turned it off.
Okay, so your red light stays on? Wait.
No.
So yours don't have a red light on?
Well, it's facing up toward the ceiling.
Oh, okay. So that's a reflection I'm looking at?
No, John, his over there.
Oh, okay. It is a reflection I'm looking at.
But yours isn't on?
No, no. Mine's on. I turned mine on.
Okay. It's possible we'll have to look and see. Mine is beside Teresa.
Oh, and maybe yours went off, okay.
And I just moved that audio recorder in case you had that.
All right, let's do a timestamp. Ready? 10:45. All right, we're going to get ready to wrap it up unless you make yourself so obviously known.
You had your opportunity. We've given you lots of opportunities this evening. We feel like we may have had some communication earlier, but we're not having any right now, so...
I don't know what that hum was. Did you guys hear that? It's not a car. Alright. Looks like we're heading out now. If you wanted to bore us...
I need to say, I just breathed and it whistled. So okay. If you hear a whistle, that was me.
Alright, if you wanted to bore us, you did a good job toward the end there.
We appreciate you trying, though.
In the middle, you did alright. In the beginning, you didn't do so good. So next time we come back, maybe you can be ready. We'll be really ready to talk to you.
Just remember who we are.
I'm Kat.
I'm John.
Teresa.
And I'm Tony.
And you can't follow any of us outside of this building.
You must stay here, but we will come back and visit you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We're wrapping up tonight's investigation. We thought we may have had some sounds that we asked for at some pertinent times. That was pretty interesting. The ghost box session was interesting also, but in a way that we can't show on television. That's sometimes you have ghost box sessions like that. We may be able to put it on our YouTube channel if what we think we heard we actually did hear. Not sure that I'm hoping that we did actually hear the things that we thought we heard because they were not very nice. Overall, it seemed pretty calm here tonight. We may have heard some sounds, may have heard some voices, I mean. And we'll be looking forward to going over our EVP evidence. Maybe we really did catch something. We think we heard the bell on that vehicle, that little fire truck vehicle, ring at least once. So hopefully that will make it into the video. Hopefully that would have made it into the audio. We hope that you enjoyed watching us sit in the dark and try to speak to possible spirits here at the old Vassalboro Schoolhouse at the Four Corners in Vassalboro. So thank you for joining us, and we hope you join us again for our next investigation. Following up on the siren sound from the investigation that we did in the Vassalboro Old Schoolhouse, we're taking a drive to see Ray right now. This is a short time later, you know. We're not on the same night. And we're gonna be there on a Friday at the same exact time in the same exact place, and we're gonna see if that's a normal sound for that night. Ray says it's not a normal sound, and I do agree because we have been in the mill agent's house countless amounts of... How many times have we been at the mill agent's house on a Friday night during the time that this sound happened, like between like 10:30 and 11? Have we ever heard a sound like that before? However it manifested itself, it was so obvious that I'm pretty sure everyone in the room just thought it was something natural. Until the very last few seconds. And then when it stopped. When it stopped is when everybody kind of perked up a little bit, because it didn't sound natural. The initial part of it sounded, it was so there. It was so real and so there. So when it was initially happening, we thought it was real. Until the very, very end, and then we realized this, there's something about this sound that doesn't quite, it doesn't quite seem natural. So that's why we need to figure out what it is. We definitely need to figure out what it is. When we came outside and we asked Ray, and he said that he had no idea what we were talking about, that just added to the questions that we already had. And we're not going to let this one go because it was just too obvious. We have something to show you.
Oh? Something new or old?
Something you may have seen already on the camcorder, but we want you to see it from the different four perspectives that we have and give us your rendition of what you think it possibly could be. We want to try to prove it as real as possible if we can, and we need your, definitely need your input on that.
You want a TV tray?
Let's get right into the kitchen. Yeah, right. This is the four of us up over the old schoolhouse over there, up in the auditorium.
Yep.
And you can see all four of us in the frame. I'm going to play the video and just... It starts fairly low, gets really loud, and then tapers off. And then just disappears.
Yeah, that's not a sound you would hear this time.
You do that again.
We're gonna start wrapping it up here pretty soon.
So you made a comment that you thought it sounded far away. When we were listening to it, we initially, I think all of us thought that it was far away until the last couple of seconds, and then when it actually stopped, it sounded like it stopped in that room.
Yeah. There's nothing in there that would make that kind
of
sound.
Does that sound at all familiar to you?
No. Yeah, all I know is civil defense used to be in there, and there used to be air horns on the fire station, but those have been long removed.
Right.
How far away is the fire station?
The original one is one block away, where they used to have air horns, but when they built the new station, everything went electronic and digital. You
know. So what's at the old one? Is it still functional?
No.
So the fire station is not, it's not functional?
No, there's nothing. Those horns were removed probably 10, 12 years ago.
Okay.
So you asked about if we were able to see that.
Yeah.
And when we bring in the sound booth, which is the tool we use for a lot of our sound analysis. See it right there? That's the sound. I'm going to zoom that in.
So that's the whole length of it?
Yep.
Wow. It's just different.
Yeah, so here's all our voices, right? And the sounds of us talking.
Yeah.
And here's that sound when it comes in. You see two wavelengths there. See that light one up above?
Yeah.
And that one right there? And that is between... This first one is between about 450, 500, and then about 900. And then the second one comes in above that, around 12.
So what frequency would create that?
We have no idea yet. That's what I came up here for, is to see if there was any kind of a sound that you would recognize. This sound happened at about 10:42, 10:45. So that's why I wanted to come up here again tonight, so we can be there at that same time frame and see if we can duplicate the zone.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that would be like the first time.
He didn't hear it outside.
Right.
He didn't hear it outside. I mean, I've never heard that sound out around here at all.
So this is probably the loudest one.
Wait, what'd she just say? What'd you just say?
I've never heard this sound from this area before.
How long have you been here?
2 years.
You've never heard that sound ever?
I've never heard that sound ever outside.
That's why we're back tonight, because we wanted to be here on the same weeknight.
Yeah, I've never heard, that sound ever.
Yeah. You can probably hear it really clear in here, and you can watch our reactions.
And any vehicle, any heavy vehicle. And it just disappeared. Like
exactly. It just comes in and just disappears.
I sleep with my window open. I sleep right next to the window every night. A lot of times I can't sleep at night. I've never heard a sound like that at night. Ever. Nothing like that.
Even if that sound was inside the building, if you sleep with your window open, it was so loud.
Right there.
Right. It was so loud. I am absolutely certain. There's no doubt in my mind how loud it was. It would have resonated outside. Somebody would have heard it. And if you were...
Oh, yeah. I
That it was loud. Yeah.
Listening to that sound.
God, it sounds like those... It sounds like those...
I told them the same thing.
Those sounds that they're just all around the United States and all over the world. They just can't explain what these sounds are. Nobody can explain what this is.
Hearing it on this computer tonight, listening to it in the audio recordings and in that video... does not do that sound justice. When we were, if you had headphones on, and you're in that environment.
It's weird how it just kind of comes in real slow.
Yeah.
And then as it ends, it goes out real, like it just fades out, like it disappears.
But it doesn't, it tapers to a point, and then it terminates.
Yeah.
Right. Just like it started. It's like it started as abruptly.
Yeah.
God, that's a weird sound. I mean, for inside of a building, I mean, I wouldn't have, you know, the sounds that, that you hear on, you watch on YouTube that people have taped, and it's just like, that's outside and that's incredibly loud, but I don't know if there's ever been any in a building, but God, it does sound like that. That's what it sounds like. Only picture that outside.
Right.
Where, like, you're in a town and you hear this sound just racking it all over the area, and everybody's looking up like, nobody can figure out what that is.
Yeah, well, that's what I was saying. If as loud as that was for us inside, if that noise was coming from outside, I can just imagine the attention that people.
This is a really quiet neighborhood. I mean, you can hear 18 wheels go by. You don't ever hear anything like that. There's no sounds like that in this area, at all.
Yeah, when you hear the trucks go by, them ties, you hear them hitting them holes, and it's rock, boom, 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 and everything rattles here.
Mm.
And it's not a motorcycle. It's not a car.
No,
it's some kind of a. It's not of anything around here. Something. I don't know.
We're inside the auditorium now. We're getting ready to do a little EVP session, which is pretty much what we were doing the first night that we heard the sound. We're pretty certain the sound came from inside the building, because if it was one of those mystery sounds that they've been hearing around the world, we've been convinced by Ray and Linda that from what they've observed, if it was a mystery sound outside, the town would have been outside trying to figure out what it was. When we got out there, it wasn't even 20 minutes later, and there was nobody in sight. So we're thinking the sound came from in here. So we're going to try to duplicate what we were doing the other night to see if maybe we can hear the sound again tonight. So here we go. Timestamp it.
10:27, 10:34, 10:38, 10:42, 10:44.
I think we've gone past the time for that sound we heard. If it was something that was on the schedule,
we have.
We're gonna give you a few more minutes. Let's go to 11. We'll give it until 9 more minutes, 8 more minutes.
We've been here for over a half hour. Some of that time we used to get ready to do this session. We've definitely gone past the time where the sound was heard the first time around. We haven't heard the sound, so we're gonna give it a few more minutes, because if it's on the schedule, then it should be heard. It should have been heard already, but we're just gonna give the situation the benefit of the doubt. We're gonna stick around for a few more minutes and see what happens.